Don't point with weapons at other people. So I'll then do this. That's basically everyone does this in the game though. So try not to do it. Second thing is do not fire behind from players. Let's say you guys are firing. I'm gonna do this with live exercise, but
what about always have our weapons on safe?
That's not in here. But basically we're attacking a position, let's say we're attacking these trucks over here. Now I'm firing, now let's say that Stefan is already firing over those, the trucks, and I'm firing behind him. Stefan, you know, Stefan needs to move for some reason, he doesn't know that I'm behind him. He's gonna move into my fire and, yeah, shit,
yeah.
He dies. So that's that.
That's especially apparent for, like, all rifles.
Blah blah blah, that's nothing else. So the other thing here is, tell your fireteam partner is, this is obviously again a nightmare in freaking server. Because people, I don't know, it's hard, first of all, it's hard from the radar to see who it is. But if you look at the icons, different people have different weapons, it's kind of easier. But, you know, basically the awareness of where somebody is. And the leader, this, I mean, it's even a nightmare to people expecting where the leader is, but, you know. That's some basic shit again.
I found him.
Dash over.
There he is. He's right in front of me.
the big things here that Beta says is plan for cover and concealment in case of contact. So you're moving somewhere. You know, we're now in the open. All you can do is get fucking lying, and that's it. If you're moving towards a tree, the next concealment is gonna be a tree. So basically, every single, I don't know, 5 seconds update. Look at your surrounding and see where you're gonna go when shit starts shooting towards you.
Shit to waste more around the sky.
Then, likely positions where the enemy is. This is, again, something people don't really do. But, yeah. You know, anything that could be... Basically, if you find yourself dying a lot, it's probably because you're not scanning for, where enemy could be at. Fire movement, this is a big stuff again. Everyone makes this mistake. I mean, people just move without any cover fire. Nope, I mean, nobody really cares about covering fire or suppressing fire or anything like that. And the big part that I hold the grudge against people is that people don't say when they're moving and covering. And that's obviously, again, these are all habits that we need to develop. And the only way we're going to develop is not by this training that we have right now, but getting on the server and them. That's what do you expect from this thing? Because what I'm expecting is the following. I'm expecting that... I mean, this is not going to be improvement from today to tomorrow, 0 to 100. It's going to be, you know, little bit by little bit, and it's going to be, probably a couple of people are going to be like, screw this, I don't want to do this because it's Canadian or whatever. But for those that who do want to do it, I'm expecting that we're going to be playing on the server. I mean, nowadays I get on the server and I just have to... You know, hold my head on where I'm gonna slot because I don't want to slot with people that are retarded. So what I would like to see
this
is that.
You're never in a squad with me. God damn it.
No, well, no, no, that's not it.
JTAC.
Look, I mean, it's just like, you know, for TBTs, what do people do? They go lone wolf, or they tend to play in the weapons team or whatever, lead it because it's smallest and there's least of
players that lead to that behavior. It's not just the players.
What do you mean?
There are other factors that lead into it.
Like what?
Quite
let's
big
not
conversation.
Get into that right now, guys. We have the training.
Yeah.
The other stuff. Let's just skip around that. So continue on, Vandal.
Yeah, one sec. No, but this is important because, you know, I'm looking, as I said, I would like to do this training as fast as possible. Make sure we're all on the same level and then get in the server. And even if we're not on the same level 100%, once we are in the server and we actually do these things, we're gonna be, you know, in 100% in no time. So, I don't know if everyone is in the same way, so... I mean, a lot of these UOTC courses, again, are... The reason I know JTAC stuff is because I do it every single time, the whole thing that the crowds taught me, so... Well, again, fire and movement, I mean, you know, say covering, moving, even the fire team shit, like, getting a bounding overwatch in the fire, in the server, you know, and making it normal that freaking one team says set, the other says bounding, it's a nightmare, so... But it's not hard, it's just people need to put it in, you know, into their habit system. Same thing as radio checks. How many times I have radio check and people just don't know how to use it. Even as simple as saying your name, people say, I can hear you, whatever. And so on and so on. So, again, I don't want to talk about this because it's... Everything is
then easy. Don't talk about it. Just skip it.
So let's get this shit done. There's the picture of what needs to be a column, actually a line. So I would say Sandiford, I'm gonna, can you just call these formation and we'll get in and you're gonna tell, see who's not doing it properly.
Okay.
All right. So Sandiford is gonna call formation. He's gonna call direction where I guess we'll for. We'll just face north, I guess.
Okay, formation line facing north.
There we go.
Just keep the spacing tight so that we can still talk and
see, nor do I do because my partner isn't here.
Just go where you would be normally.
Just don't worry about your partner, just imagine you're two guys.
Wixie, you're on my... There we go.
I think.
So, one thing I noticed in Arma, it's really hard to, like, right now it took us like an age to do this. And that's because everyone is trying to get in the right stuff, but in, I think in, like, I would treat it as, like your BMS simulation. Like, you have your lead, and then you have, and then you're a wingman. So, Jelner, you should be the last guy. Basically, you should be the guy who moves in, and then you stand still. And then your body
I know.
Positions off of you and so on.
With my game pros.
Okay,
I need to
anyway, that's
left.
My interpretation of the shit, so.
Yeah.
Sandy, are we good right now?
No, we should be over here.
Hold on, I'm working out.
No, I'm on your lot.
Okay, which is in the wrong position? Which is on the left of squad leader, and which should be on the right of squad leader?
Yeah, which you mean you're on the right of squad leader just now,
wait,
so.
What?
Would you stay left of me, but right of squad lead?
Okay, Cassidy.
Cassidy, oh, well. Left of squad lead.
Yeah, he moved. Again.
No, I'm still standing here.
No.
Okay, now it's looking good. And okay, bear in mind that if we had Yakto here, Yakto would be on the very left flank, so we'd have a machine gun on each flank.
Alright, Roger. So this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna execute these formations. We're gonna start switching
Redding,
with them,
Redding
and then we're gonna try to get like, we're just gonna see how, you know, we need to
Redding
just do these like
over.
10 times or whatever, and then we'll see who still has problems with it. So go ahead and call next formation, I guess, and we'll go with that.
Yeah, Red, you on the left, Witchy on the right.
No, he's on the left.
No,
you
are on the left.
Oh, is he? Yeah, I swear that.
Okay, so
by the
just
way,
swapping over Red and Witchy.
I know this looks retarded, but this is the basics, guys.
Okay, remember, order doesn't necessarily have to be exact. If you want to swap over between your fire team, the two fire team members, you can do, depending on the situation. It's not absolutely vital if there's a good reason. One section formation facing north, arrowhead.
Come on guys, it must be easy to get from line to arrowhead, just run back.
Basically.
I missed my Yaxa.
Missing one battle dude on the left flank.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah. You're looking good, it's just checking it's not here. Okay, this is looking good.
One section, formation file facing north.
Yeah, so you're in front of me.
What? Am I in the front?
Get the fuck out of the way, Reddish.
Really? Wait, hold on. Where's
yeah, you're on point.
Cassie, you're behind
yeah.
the squad leader. In front of me.
You can choose to swap that. The squad leader can choose to swap that over if he wants to.
Which you be happy?
Good. This is easier for me, I can just stand.
Correct. One section formation staggered file facing north.
Incorrect.
Okay, the way we do staggered file is that Alpha Fire Team is on the left, then the whole of Bravo Fire Team on the right, then the whole of Charlie on the left, then the whole of Delta on the right.
We're on the right side. You know,
Reddish, you're in. You're what's it, what Fire Team are you in?
Fighting Charlie, so.
Okay.
Yeah, fighting Bravo.
Okay, this is looking good.
Person.
Correct. Return to file.
Yeah, these names are even confusing, right?
A small note on the staggered file. Generally, the fire team members will be close together, so they're like 5 meters together, just quite tightly bunched. Now, let's do echelon left.
What? Well, 1 point.
Echelon left. Basically, we just stay in place. You shift slightly right.
Okay, you'll notice that file, staggered file, and echelon left and echelon right are Alpha, Bravo, Charlie, Delta, whereas line and arrowhead are Bravo, Alpha, Charlie, Delta. That's so that Alpha is always in the one point or in the middle. And that's all the formations.
Basically, yeah. Alright, you wanna just dribble us a little bit, just mix it up, like, pick five formations and let's mix it up again, just for fun.
Okay. One section facing north, formation arrowhead.
This is easy.
God damn it. I think this is easy.
Formation staggered file.
What's staggered file?
Yeah, just go in front of me.
Yeah, I think I'm almost always on point except for
maybe behind the
center
leader, British.
Yeah.
Oh. You should step to your right as well, so you're directly behind spot leader.
Yeah, we're good here.
Yeah.
Formation line.
Extend the line to the west because we don't have room here.
Double spacing, extend to the west.
We're gonna play the telephone game. Guys, I think it has to be 50 meters or more. Is it good now?
About one ring on the tractor card is good, that's 15 meters. You'll notice, if the squad leader's talking, you won't be able to hear it on the end of the line. So, this is why we won't always have it for free, so you need to practice passing messages along, and I'll let Rammer continue now.
To the west. So, which you need to get in next circle, because you're in line.
It's not that important.
More left, guys.
Okay, so... Alright, this is what we're gonna do. Zed is gonna start the message, and then the last person in the line who should be, who is that? That's 101 Alpha. Irby, you're gonna call them on the radio, okay? Then, Zed is gonna say if it's correct or not. The wheel is round. No, you messed it up. You messed it up, man. You don't use the radio, only the last guy does, so we see what it is.
Sunshine's always bright.
What?
Where are
we? I have no idea what you said, I can barely hear you. You're not loud enough.
Sunshine is always bright.
What?
Sunshine is always bright.
Cassie, you're like...
Sunshine is always bright, Irby!
Sunshine is always bright.
Or maybe bright?
It was sunshine bright. Is always bright.
What I said, he just
it was an example.
I can't hear you, Cassie.
You absolutely have to pay attention.
I'm gonna have to turn your sound, Cassie, because you're like super quiet.
No, it's you turn me down, everything's fine.
Do we pass the message back over to the other side now? Alright, gentlemen, there. Do you see BMP in the woods or something? Make something up and go ahead and pass it. Actually, do a complicated one, like BMP and then call how many dismounts are or something.
So squad is going to call something out and we can pass along the line both directions. Just use the squad leader and they're going to pass it along the line both ways.
Messages start on squad leader and being passed both ways.
Okay. I'll say that again, I was talking to you.
Oh, BMP Southwest, 5 dismounts.
BMP Southwest, 5 dismounts.
BMP Southwest, 5 dismounts.
BMP Southwest, 5
BMP
dismounts.
BMP Southwest, 5 dismounts. BMP West, 5 dismounts.
But you have no buttons.
Yeah. Say it on the radio.
BMP West 5 dismounts. What he said.
Okay, I think this is it.
Yeah.
Alright guys, basically that's that. This is important for your whack, I guess. And obviously nobody's doing it, I mean on the server. More or less, no. So, you see how it's important.
Sandy, I think we can go with the,
yep.
The bounding, that's all.
Okay. Get him in a truck, unless you want to use this range.
I think the range is fine.
If you want to use this one.
The range is fine. I don't think it matters.
Yeah. You can start, just start it in the field here, just doing it walking pace and then move to the range and do...
Yeah, okay. Well.
Okay guys, what we're going to do is, what is it, see, I didn't even know the name still. We're gonna do a line.
We're gonna do a line, right?
Yeah, just get everyone close up, close spacing, so you can hear each easily, and then...
Guys, we're gonna do a line facing west, starting on the road.
Line west on the road, and bringing in the spacing nice and tight so you can hear each other easily.
Taking a long time.
Yep.
Good night, guys.
Where should they go?
A good thing when you're forming a line is for the squad leader to make lots of noise so everyone knows where the squad leader is and then they can orient on him.
Yeah.
Copy that.
Okay.
The next thing I would say we need to fix the bounding stuff for the fast evasive forward.
Bring the line in so you can hear Rambo.
How are we bounding so in the first place?
Okay, guys. The next thing is what we're gonna do is we're gonna do bound and basically he sees me, I'm up, he sees me, I'm down, he doesn't, or I don't even know how you freaking say it.
I'm up, 3 seconds, he sees me, I'm down.
There you go, that's it. Okay, and one of the things that's important here is that you can get off the ground real fast. So like... So, that key to do that is evasive forward, I believe. And if you don't have it bound, you should bind it to W, 2xW.
Evasive forward?
Yeah. Well,
it's also called speed application.
If you don't have it bound, try, get down on the ground and see how fast you can. In fact, we can test it.
Who doesn't have it bound?
Jack,
am I pressing like sprint?
Go prone and then just press your sprint key and you should get up.
Yeah, if you don't get.
If you don't get up while you're down by pressing W, then you don't have it.
It's a demonstration.
Evasive forward, was it?
Yeah.
Evasive forward, bind it to double tap W if you use that for sprint.
It looks just, the movement looks a lot fluid, more fluid than it actually is.
Every button.
Cassius, got it. Milne?
Yeah, I'm just bound it.
Okay. Show me. That was good.
I know I'm good. I'm fucking awesome, dude.
Oh, does it
stop you automatically? You got.
Alright.
No.
Just sprint and that at the same time, huh?
Okay, anyone
right
not
got
it?
Stop you automatically? Cast your everyone's up.
Give me a demonstration, British.
Yeah.
We can cut the grass.
Butchie?
Yeah, we all cut the grass. We're laying down.
Yep, cool.
Does everyone see how that happens?
Yeah. Alright, what we're gonna do now is we should just demonstrate the bounding in two elements and forward. I think you should initiate and I'm gonna just bound with you.
But you might wanna explain how we bound in the first place.
It's amazing.
Okay, well. The whole bounding stuff, you should reference the
Stefan, can you come with me?
Reference the pictures made by Sandy.
Rambo, can you talk over the radio, because I can't hear you?
Yeah.
If you can be, Herbie's buddy.
Hi, buddy.
End of the line.
You have an MG.
I have no weapon, but yeah.
On the ground. On the ground, Stefan. Turn around, goddammit, Stefan.
I don't really need an MG, do I?
Yeah, you do.
Well then, watch this magic trick.
Hey, Sam, do you want to demonstrate the bounding just in, what is it, the Fireteam?
What's up, Rambo?
Do you want to demonstrate the bounding real quick?
Demonstrate what, like, just with me and one other person?
Yeah, just me and you.
Okay, yep, just come out here.
You need a gun though, aren't you?
Nah, it's alright, we'll just... Stay down.
Right, you're gonna be initiating.
Facing 190. I'm
gonna
advance,
go on your left.
190. Yeah, access advance 190. Bounding, team. So
right.
I'm gonna wait to hear covering or shooting.
Covering.
Moving.
I'm trying to move, but I'm doing a throwing animation. Okay, now move.
No. Covering. Bang, bang, bang. Bang, bang, bang. Bang, bang, bang.
We should do a saw.
Bang, bang, bang.
Covering.
Moving. Covering.
Moving.
Bang, bang, bang. Bang, bang, bang. Bang, bang, bang.
Covering.
Bang, bang. Moving.
So you get the idea.
Yeah. So it's successive, I think. Yeah, it's successive bounding overwatch.
Successive bounding, so you move up to the person, you only move up to the person, not past them. Immediately before you move, you should do a shoulder check, so just look left and right and make sure you're not going to run in front of anyone's lanes. And also before you move, just take your time and make sure you hear the person next to you is covering or firing before you move anywhere.
Alright, what we're going to do now is we're going to have each fire team execute that. Just the same way we did during 180. As soon as everyone's got that, we're going to deal with the group shit.
When we bound up as a part
So Alpha, you guys move up to the green smoke or wherever it was and start bounding 180.
We're Bravo, by the way.
Bravo.
Just
keep that in mind.
Help, bring it back. Casa, you need to come back here, and you only run up to the person in front in line with them, not past them. Okay, so you come to where I am now. Yep. So this is where you stop. You never get past him. I've got my Jacob off.
Same.
Okay, Bravo team.
Yeah, make it closer though. I mean, basically, just the senior guy should be basically on top of the road almost, so people can hear you and see you.
Yeah, bring it over here, guys.
I think you're the senior guy.
I am.
Senior guy is in Bravo case.
Stefan.
Yaxo, but
so Stefan, yeah. So Stefan. You should be my left, Stefan.
Okay, come over here, Stefan. Bravo fire team, bounding. Team.
Moving. Covering. Bang.
Moving.
Bang. Bang.
Covering.
Moving.
Yeah, that's it.
Bang.
Kaboom! Bang. That was me firing my grenade.
Moving.
Covering. Bang. Bang.
Covering.
Moving.
Bang bang, ba bang bang bang.
Bang, covering, bang.
Moving.
Bang.
Well, the distance between the two bang. Of you needs to be a little bigger so you don't shoot each other in the back.
Okay, you notice what's happening at the moment is that you're converging, you're getting closer together. And that's because Stefan is following the road while Herbie is heading towards 180. So you just need to make sure you're aware of your axis of advance and you should stay level.
Yeah.
Just keep an eye on your buddies.
Yeah, it's good for the first try though. Okay, now it's Charlie.
Okay, my game's just frozen a bit.
Nice.
Yeah, if I crash, I'll just reconnect.
Can you hear me? Good over there? I can hear you. Bounding.
Yeah, my game's crashed. I'll be right back.
You're covering already.
Covering.
And he's moving, so... Yeah.
Bounding.
The expressions are moving and covering.
Covering.
And basically count to three, yeah, 1, 2, 3. And...
I'm up, he sees me, I'm down.
There you go.
Covering. And bounding. Bounding. Covering.
That's good.
Alright, now we got me and Zaz. So, we got 200. Ready?
Delta team, bounding. Team.
Moving. Covering.
Moving. Covering.
Moving. Covering.